13 minutes away from 9 o'clock, so good to have you here this morning. If today's property press is anything to go by, and I grabbed it, had a quick read of it, a four-bedroom home, $450,000, $500,000 is waiting for you here in Nelson. All you got to do is jump on a plane, get here and buy it. So is it time that more New Zealanders move to the regions? Is it a good investment? Debbie Roberts from Property Apprentice joins us now. Debbie usually joins us in Auckland. She decided, oh, Nelson's so hot, I'm coming where you are. Nice to see you, Debbie.
Thank you for having me back.
If I say to you the regions, you say to me what?
I say regions are a great alternative to looking at the main centres, but obviously it depends on what your starting position is. Not everyone can afford to buy in the main centres anymore, and certainly cash flows dried up. So there's benefits to investing in the main centres, and that is that long-term capital growth in the main centres is always the best over the long term. In the regions, though, you tend to get better cash flow. So if you're looking for an investment property for cash flow, the regions is a great alternative.
And that's the thing. The first person I met here this morning, when we were sitting on set at 5:45, a lady came up to me and gave us all muffins, Marilena. Marilena came up to us, gave us the muffins. I said, where'd you come from? Are you from Nelson? She goes, came from Auckland 2 years ago for the community. And that says a lot too. It didn't say housing, but I mean, if you have a look around here, the houses are, for such an attractive area, affordable, aren't they?
Absolutely. As far as rental returns go, Nelson, you'll be pretty hard pressed to get some cash flow out of rentals in Nelson.
What do you mean by that? You wouldn't cover
Yeah, the rent won't cover the mortgage, let alone any of the other expenses. So there are a lot of alternatives outside of the main centres which do make good investments.
I'm all ears for this. where would be the best place, do you think, to sort of invest at the moment?
So it really does depend on what position you're in to start with, what level of risk you feel comfortable with, you know, how comfortable you feel about investing outside of the area that you live in. Paul and myself have bought and sold properties as far south as Invercargill when we were living in Auckland. So investing outside of the area that you live in is not that difficult if you know how to do it and if you know the best places to look. So my advice to you, if you're looking at finding cash flow positive properties, which are definitely out there, my advice would be to stay away from the small towns with shrinking populations, because over the long term, that doesn't make for a good investment.
What about tourism-driven towns as opposed to, you know, small business-driven towns? Because that's different as well. Queenstown, tourism-driven. I know it's expensive, but other smaller venues are tourism-driven as opposed to vibrant business-driven.
Yeah, so this is one of the interesting things that we find is that people get interested in property investment because of capital gain, right? But capital gain's only one part of the equation when it comes to property investment. Yes, it's important in the big picture, but having your cash flow covering your costs is more important, because if you've got a portfolio of properties that cover their costs, you don't have to keep topping it up out of your own back pocket each week. And so it's a combination of balancing capital growth and cash flow. The main centres are always going to be the best for long-term capital growth, just because of population growth and all those sort of things. Smaller towns in the regions, ones with shrinking populations, nightmare. You know, the cash flow can look really good, but if there's only one main industry in that town and that industry goes broke, there goes your tenant pool.
We're talking to some of those zombie towns, aren't we? But this is not one of those ones.
It's all right. Shane Jones got $1 billion to spend on those towns.
Yeah, Shane Jones been in this town giving money away, because, you know, he might be coming. Hey, good on you, Debbie. Always nice to see you.
Thanks
for coming into Nelson as well. Debbie Roberts, our property apprentice. Who feels like a beer?
Me.
Who feels like a beer budget?